Historically, winters with light snowfall have led to devastating droughts. Even in years with heavy winter snowfall, the normal flows in our rivers and streams can drop to dangerously low levels by late summer if the snow melts too quickly. We rely heavily on precipitation that fell many years ago and has been stored in glacial ice, natural lakes, or percolated into underground aquifers. Consequently, our water development agencies have constructed storage reservoirs or have used wells to tap into the natural underground reservoirs. So, we have two sources of water. Surface water, that is water in streams, rivers, lakes, and reservoirs, and groundwater. Today, Utah's water management agencies carefully balance the use of both sources. This is often referred to as the conjunctive use of surface water and groundwater.
That's the way it is in a desert. You either sometimes have more than you can handle, or you don't have enough to sustain everything that you need. And that's why we build water projects. That's why we build dams to store it in times of plenty. And that's why the distribution systems are built the way they are.
But these water projects and distribution systems and the agencies which control them often overlap. Many of them may be involved in the storage, transmission, treatment, and final delivery of water to our taps. So determining where your water comes from may be more complicated than simply naming your city water company. To fully understand where our water comes from, we have to start at its source. The bulk of surface water supplies in northern Utah originate high in the Wasatch and Uinta Mountains. While numerous streams, creeks, and rivers drain off these mountain ranges, they can be divided into four major water systems or basins: the Bear, Weber, and Provo Jordan Rivers, all of which flow into the Great Salt Lake, and the Duchesne River. Irrigation companies converted many of the natural lakes on the tributaries of these rivers into reservoirs early in the 20th century. Some remain in use, while others are being restored as the water storage function is moved to newer reservoirs downstream, such as Jordanelle and the Big Sand Wash Reservoir. The large storage reservoirs on these rivers, with few exceptions, were built by the Bureau of Reclamation and are operated by the Water Conservancy Districts, or Water Users Associations. These districts or associations assumed the obligation of repaying the federal government for the initial funding. The Bear River flows northward from this common area into Wyoming. Several small reservoirs along its course, including Bear Lake, store water for irrigation and culinary use. A significant portion of the river water, in the form of heavy spring runoff, still flows unused into the Great Salt Lake. Several streams flow off the northwest face of the Uinta Mountains to form the Weber and Ogden River systems.
Before the water ever gets to our tap in our home, our water travels through a complex series of water facilities, starting with diversion structures and dams and reservoirs upstream on the river system. In our case, our reservoirs all operate in unison to supply one large water supply for our customer areas. We also have Moss Creek Reservoir and East Canyon Reservoir, which are on tributaries to the Weber River, are located about mid-water basin. And then on the mainstream of the Weber River, we have Rockport Reservoir. Moving over to the Ogden River side, we have Causey Reservoir, which is located near Monte Cristo and in Weber County, and then Pineview Reservoir, which is in Ogden Valley, just above the Wasatch Range. After the water leaves those reservoirs, it's then diverted through a series of canals and pipelines and aqueducts that bring it on downstream to the population centers.
Seven of the dams on the Weber River are operated by Weber Basin Water Conservancy District and provide roughly 400,000 acre-feet of the district's water supply. The district also operates three drinking water treatment plants and related distribution systems constructed between 1959 and 1962, in addition to 17 deep, large-capacity wells to increase supply and capacity.
Our infrastructure is by and large 50 years old. Much of the federal project that we operate was built during the 1950s. And we have a few specific challenges on dams and reservoirs, spillways, power stations, and such that are requiring a lot of rehab now that hasn't been required in the past. And we estimate in the next 20 years we'll almost all have to be rebuilt.
Weber Basin Water acts as a wholesaler of drinking water to cities and other districts and agencies that deliver water to approximately 425,000 people in its five counties. Water draining southwest from the lakes and streams of the High Uintas form the Provo River system. Downstream, the flows of the Provo River are augmented by the water diverted from the Duchesne River through a tunnel, where it provides one-third of the water stored in Deer Creek Reservoir. Before entering Deer Creek, the water first passes through the larger Jordanelle Dam and Reservoir. The Jordanelle Dam is operated by the Central Utah Water Conservancy District. Controversial during its construction, today the reservoir forms an important municipal supply capable of annual water deliveries of 90,000 acre-feet per year.
Then I remember people, after we got it pretty well under construction, people told us we would never fill it. There was never enough water on the Provo to fill the reservoir, and once we got it finished and closed the gates on it, it was a very few years till we had it full right to the top.
Water from Deer Creek and Jordanelle is delivered to its users in four different conveyance systems: the Salt Lake Aqueduct, the Jordan Aqueduct, the Murdoch Canal, or through Utah Lake and the canals along the Jordan River. The Salt Lake Aqueduct is operated by the Metropolitan Water District of Salt Lake and Sandy and runs from Deer Creek to the east side of the Salt Lake Valley. Water is diverted from the Provo River to the Olmsted Diversion and then on to the Utah Valley Water Treatment Plant, or the Jordan Valley Water Treatment Plant in Salt Lake County. The Jordan Valley District delivers treated water at several points along the pipeline to retail agencies, municipalities, and service districts, which purchase large blocks of water on a wholesale basis. The retail agencies handle the final delivery of the water to their customers' taps. On the Provo River, downstream from the Olmsted Diversion, is a second diversion structure, the Murdoch Canal. Originally built in 1910, it was later expanded to the point of the mountain and across the Jordan Narrows in connection with the construction of Deer Creek. The canal is operated by the Provo River Water Users Association and provides irrigation water, but can also be used to deliver water to the water treatment plants in the Salt Lake Valley. Water also flows out of the Uinta Mountains to the south and east into the Duchesne River and its tributaries, which in turn flows towards the Colorado River. As we've already seen, a portion of the Duchesne River is diverted through a tunnel into the Provo River. Additional water is diverted from its tributaries at other points as part of the Central Utah Project. As originally conceived, the CUP would have diverted water from all of the major streams draining off the southern face of the Uintas to the Wasatch Front and the Sevier River Basin. The original water users in the Uinta Basin would then be supplied with water diverted directly from the Green River. Over time, politics and economics led the Bureau to scale back and slow down the project. Congress authorized the CUP 50 years ago. The bulk of the project is now complete. The Bonneville unit transfers water from the Colorado drainage to the Wasatch Front. Today, water is diverted from Rock Creek, the Duchesne, and Current Creek through a series of pipelines and tunnels into the enlarged Strawberry Reservoir. A new system of tunnels and pipelines conveys the water through the Diamond Fork drainage. The bulk of the water is kept in the pipes to prevent excessive erosion and other environmental damage to Diamond Fork Creek. The completed system allows Jordanelle to function by fulfilling water rights in Utah Lake and storing water from the Provo River in Jordanelle.
And I think I can tell you that without the Central Utah Project and its resulting features, the last 4 or 5 years of this drought, Salt Lake County would have been on severe water rationing without the project and the facilities that we've been able to put in place.
Other CUP dams benefit the Uinta Basin. Steinecker, Red Fleet, and Starvation provide both irrigation and municipal water. Additionally, the district has recently completed the expansion of the Big Sand Wash Reservoir. During the same time the Bureau of Reclamation planned the CUP, they also planned a project to benefit southern Utah. In anticipation of the project, the Washington County Water Conservancy District was created in 1962. While Congress authorized the Dixie Project, further investigation of the proposed dam sites determined they were unsuitable. While the Dixie Project was never developed, the Washington County Water Conservancy District continued to promote regional water development in southern Utah. In 1982, using funds borrowed from the Utah State Water Board, the district began construction on the Quail Creek Reservoir. Rather than dam the Virgin River directly, Quail Creek is built in a basin away from the river. Water is then diverted through a pipeline to fill the reservoir. The district successfully completed the project in 1985. The reservoir is capable of storing 40,000 acre-feet of water. Projecting the need for more water, the district began planning for a second off-stream reservoir to be fed from Quail Creek. After several years of planning, the district began construction of the 50,000 acre-foot Sand Hollow Reservoir in 2000. The project, completed in 2003, provides additional municipal water to the region, but also serves as a groundwater recharge project. The porous sandstone allows water to percolate into the aquifer to compensate for withdrawals made from wells in other locations. These numerous projects, operated by Utah's numerous water agencies, provide us with our water supply today. These reservoirs act as a savings account, banking water away during wet periods to help in times of drought. In many cases, these projects were built during the last century with the assistance of the Bureau of Reclamation. These projects, combined with many pioneer-era projects, provide the bulk of water for Utah's homes, businesses, and industry.